chest pokud tu tak prista krenko. Jak ovka.
Yes, I bet you have.
Welcome back to the cantina. I am sitting on the stairs, kind of taking a time out from cleaning the house and doing stuff like that. I want to talk a little bit about how we got to this point in our culture where untalented writers, so-called musicians, so-called singers who have to use auto-tune to make themselves sound like they can carry a tune. How do we get to this point? Well, first off, this video may end up being a two-parter because there are two things going on here. One is the retreat of normies like us from the culture. And the other is, as we were retreating from it, cultural Marxists were jumping in. What's cultural Marxism? Well, look at the Frankfurt School. By the way, Wikipedia likes to say that this term is right-wing propaganda. Actually, no, it's not, because if you start studying it, you realize that they were very proud of the theory they created. And they're implementing it now, and they have been for decades. So let's talk. What is culture? Culture is heritage, language, music, art, literature, stories, passed down from one generation to another. It is the backdrop of a society. It tells the society's story. It is the entertainment. It is the conversation. It is what people read and write and talk about and listen to. If you go to any, you go to Ireland, the Irish have a very specific kind of music. Italy, specific language, specific music. Germany, same thing. Culture is not global, okay? The closest thing you can get to actually a global culture that's not global is the American culture. Yes, McDonald's, yes, blah, blah, blah. This is the culture that created the movie industry, all right? We are the ones, okay? We are the ones that took a new medium that composed of performance art, music, art, painting, drawing, three-dimensional art, statues, and turned it into one art form, the film, cinema. And it is an ever-changing technological field, and it is amazing when you have a great director like George Lucas, Steven Spielberg, Ridley Scott, go all the way to John Ford, David Lynch, etc., and look and see what they were able to accomplish using all those mediums of art to create a film, which is in and of itself a medium of art, right? But there's a flip side to it. I want you to go look, and I've talked about this before, but go look at the films of the Soviet Union, the propaganda films of China, propaganda films of Nazi Germany, right? Nothing can put a political message out there better than film. Okay, so why we know what, and the people who are making movies now, the Michael Moores, even the Robert Redfords, who's somebody I actually do respect, a lot of hardcore leftists, and when I say Robert Redford, I'm not looking at him like a cultural Marxist. He's just a Democrat, very into protecting the environment, la-di-da, not my cup of tea. But I don't hate him, right? He's not one of them. He's not a Michael Moore. He's not a, one of these people. And while we were getting married, taking care of our families, going to school, getting jobs in industry, business, what have you. Guys that were bad, we're getting into the movies. Lucasfilm is inundated with cultural Marxists. I mean, Paulo Hidalgo called himself a leftist dirtbag. All right. How do I know it's cultural Marxism? Look at the elevation of Captain Marvel. Replacing a male hero, be it black or white, with a white female hero. All right. Telling men they're not needed. All right. Taking society's norms and saying they're wrong. All right. This happens in a lot of movies. All right. We got Batwoman on TV. First off, it's a piece of shit show. And when you're losing money on something, and you know they're not. I mean, why? I know why. Because they're cultural Marxists and they're trying to make what this woman does and what she is the norm rather than the, you know, that's what cultural Marxism does. Go to Star Wars. We've got the white goddess Rey. And what they do with her is they take everything that a liberal, George Lucas is not a conservative, a liberal like George Lucas, who created a fairy tale, a Western, a space soap opera with the definite male heroes, Luke Skywalker, Anakin Skywalker, Han Solo, and they are basically ground into the dirt to uplift this white female hero. And it wasn't so apparent, well, it was apparent in the Force Awakens. I mean, turning Han into whatever he was supposed to be is the quintessential devaluing of the heroic. This is what cultural Marxism does. Now, we all remember that deconstruction of heroes is a big thing to the lefties now in Hollywood. And there's a difference between an anti-hero and a hero, okay? This is not turning Han Solo into an anti-hero. This is basically removing any of his accomplishments, any of his goals, all of the personality that made him a legend to, you know, people who saw the movies, you know, 40 years ago, into this less than decent human being, which is, okay, it's got that. And there's enough gray area to where you allow young women and older women who don't have any lives to identify with his killer. They feel sorry for him. They look at Ben Solo, Kylo Ren as a victim. When in reality, when you, even in their own canon, which is cultural Marxist 101, it's so obvious now to me, it's like, whatever. Ben Solo was the one who victimized everybody. His mother, his father, his uncle, la-di-da, okay? Go on further. So we have Han's character deconstructed and butchered. TLJ goes into the very intricate ways of deconstructing Luke Skywalker. This is why people are angry. Even liberals are angry. Because they saw someone they believed in, a character they believed in, being run through the meat grinder for no good purpose except to uplift someone that is considered a victim, who is the antagonist. Someone who didn't deserve to be where she is, but before she's a woman, a female, and her journey is far easier than Luke's ever was, than Anakin's ever was. Okay. All right. We have, what's interesting is at least in TFA, the ascent of Finn was notable. TLJ, he was back into being the step and fetch. All right. Which I'm going to say this. Cultural Marxists are racists, okay? Now, you can have a Latino being a cultural Marxist. You can have a white woman being a cultural Marxist. You can have an Asian woman being a cultural Marxist. But they're racists, okay? They're either racist against anything that's white, anything that's Western, anything of value, mythology, heroism, the anything that is valuable to a culture, our culture, is to them fair game to destroy because they hate it and they want to rewrite it and deny the people they think that it was for their, I don't know, identity. I just, to me, when I think about this, it's ludicrous. But again, we were all going to college. We were all getting degrees. We were all working, raising families, and we stepped away from the culture. We, you know, didn't listen to the music. We didn't realize that Taylor Swift can't sing. She can't. We didn't listen to the disgusting lyrics of some of the rap singers. We didn't listen or pay attention to the more politicized, subversive to society TV shows that were going on, and of course, film. The nihilism, because the essence of cultural Marxism is nihilism, okay? The more nihilistic a movie is, the more culturally Marxist it is. Fine, all right? The reason why I say this is because it needs to be talked about. We were a part of this. And we have allowed them to build their own echo chamber. This is why Ricky Gervais, who's as left wing as the next guy, gets yelled at and shrieked at by, you know, leftists in Hollywood, because he called them out and they don't want to hear about it. They want an echo chamber where there's no other opinion but theirs. That is the essence of cultural Marxism. And if you look at their movies, if you look at TLJ, what was the side trip to Canto Bight? It was nothing more than a place for Rose Tico to, you know, testify to the great Maoist doctrine that, I mean, look at her. Look at how they dressed Kelly Murray Tran. Mrs. Mao, table for four. You know, think about it. May I get to The Rise of Skywalker? Completely undermines the rest of Star Wars. Disney is a global company. They don't feel like they have a responsibility to protect the integrity of these stories when they're trying to get a global audience. And what's weird, and this is how short-sighted cultural Marxists are, what's weird is Star Wars had a great global audience before they ever got their hands on it. It did. You know, they want the Chinese box office. The Chinese aren't going to respond to a story based on Western mythology, Greco-Roman mythology, Arthurian legends, Nordic legends, Westerns, stories. They're not. But other cultures do. Europeans do. Western cultures do. But again, Disney's a global company. Cultural Marxism is a global philosophy. There you go. Okay. This is why, instead of, you know, bringing in something new and truly tying the Clone Wars and everything to the saga, they left Matt Smith on the cutting room floor. This is why, instead of following the circle, which George Lucas was doing, trying to do a circle and bring everything together, which is what a saga is, they denied Rey Solo to give us Rey Palpatine. I'm gonna say this. Reylo's started to get obnoxious during TFA, but after TFA came out, but they weren't so awful. Rian Johnson, who is a cultural Marxist, he's a hardcore red. I mean, Knives Out is a fuck you to everybody who's like normal, all right? He understood what this phenomenon could be and where in the fact that it could actually take attention away to what the story should have been about and turn it into something it's not supposed to be about and fuck it up in a way that the idiots at Disney couldn't figure out how to get out from under it. That's what he did. He's not smart, but he is clever. Okay? Reylo is a cultural Marxist phenomena, okay? And when you start looking at the things they say about men, it's very obvious that cultural Marxism is very much alive and well in third wave feminism, because they don't do it because they like Kyle Rahn. They do it because they hate men, okay? I mean, and that's the bottom line. Why else would they? Han's fault that he turned out that way. Well, actually, no. It's really Fuckstick's fault he ended up that way, but okay. So this is what it is. And the reason why it is this way, the reason why Pablo Hidalgo, his wife, and others at Lucasfilm can infiltrate and then set fire to what George Lucas built is because those of us stepped away from it when we should have gone, I can do that too. I want to work for Lucasfilm. All right. Now, if you had actually fans of Star Wars writing the novels, Claudia Gray is a huge Marxist. Rey Carson is a huge Marxist. Daniel Jose Older is a giant anti-white Latino Marxist. He hates Han Solo. He hates him. Rey Carson basically admitted when she wrote the Solo novel that she wanted to shit all over Han Solo and wrote the book about the bitch Queera, the slag, all right? Because somehow in her walnut-sized brain, her mentally ill, mentally incompetent, uneducated walnut-sized brain, Queera is more important in a Han Solo novel than Han Solo is. Why? White man bad, all right? The essence of this cultural Marxism is white man bad, because white man, Han Solo, Harrison Ford, Mark Hamill, George Lucas, represent Western values, Western society, male heroism, male courage, all right? The get the stuff done thing, right? And that's why Claudia Gray, Rey Carson, yada, 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 write these flaming feminist attacks on men and within the Star Wars universe any chance they can. They hide behind the thing they call representation. I mean, and it's like, but the story's bad. They don't care. They're not doing it. They don't write good stories. They're writing Marxist, cultural Marxist doctrine. Okay. I just kind of want to talk a little bit about this only because it was something we needed to talk about. And, you know, again, part of it's our fault. The audience's fault. We expected them to do what they were supposed to do, take care of Han, Luke, and Leia, and they didn't. They were on the attack anywhere they could, any chance they could be. And that's what we got. Destroyed. I mean, Palpatine coming back. A is not only lazy writing, it's Marxist doctrine. All right. Don't inspire anything new. It can't be inspiring. It has to be schlock for the masses. That's exactly why they're bringing Kevin Feige in. Kevin Feige is the Disney's big burger flipper of pink slime from Marvel. Okay? That's what it is. There aren't any deep underlying truths going on. At the end, I saw a great compilation of news stories, videos on YouTube here about Star Wars, and it was very interesting. Tom Brokaw and others were saying what a simple, elegant story with no real moral message or anything, just pure escapism. But, you know, yeah, it was pure escapism, but it was more than that. Star Wars is supposed to be our story, the hero's journey, the mythology behind it. And this is why it resonated. It was inspired. And cultural Marxist art, The Force Awakens, TLJ, The Rise of Skywalker, Solo, are not inspired art. Ultimately, they're propaganda, which is why you never hear, you know, the shell saying, oh, it's so deep in me. No, it wasn't. You know, if you honestly think TLJ was a deep and meaningful film, you're a lying sack of crap, because it wasn't. It was right in your face. It was right in your face what it was about. Okay. And, you know, they knew the moment they got their hands on Lucasfilm and the franchise what they were going to do to it. We will tear it apart, and we will turn it into politically correct slime for these stupid idiots who are going to go see it. Because here's the thing about Marxists. If you ever follow Pablo before he basically went private on social media, he would talk down to people smarter than everybody else. And that's the thing about these people, all right? Kathy Kennedy, Ryan Johnson, start yanking names out of Lucasfilm who have bothered and harassed, the fans who are upset. You're too stupid to understand what they're trying to do. Just accept it or go away. Well, you know, I ain't going away. None of you have to go away either, okay? We're Star Wars fans. We're here for the long haul, and we're not going to let them do this. Star Wars, in the end, is more meaningful to those of us who are willing to fight for it than anything. It's not something that you can just take and wad up into a trash can and throw it away. It's Star Wars. Okay. It defined generations. Okay. Gen X, Gen Y, who are like, you know, and this is why we're here. And all you have to do is realize that what George Lucas created stimulated something in the heart, the soul, that nothing Disney has ever created has done. And the high band, it's for kids. so they can indoctrinate them. Which is what they, I mean, again, cultural Marxists are globalists. This is why they wanted Lucasfilm so bad. Steph sending out Zero in the Galaxy, Zero in the Cantina. Remember that Wookiee bartender's 20%. No droids about Anders, so Raylows, fuck them. Sword fight, take out in the alley. Gunfights, take the shit out in the street. Zero in the Galaxy.